I'm asking, is that
No. Do I follow just Quran?
So why did you have the stuff then?
No.
Why did you debate other stuff?
No. See, are you willing to debate me?
I am. Why do you debate
He's
other stuff?
Shamsi. No, forget all other stuff. Are you willing to debate
me? You're not even meeting your own standards.
He challenged me, and I'm challenged. Come debate me.
Listen, if you're
what is my challenge? Do you know what the topic is?
You want to debate me, correct?
Yeah, I'm going to
bring
a topic.
You come for debate.
Can I bring a topic?
No, why you have to bring it?
Because I'm the one coming to you.
But you are asking me to debate
listen,
you.
He's coming to you.
I'm the topic.
And
you're
I don't want to debate you any topic except this
why?
One.
Why are you free?
Because Prophet Muhammad SAW said, as a Muslim who followed the Quran and the Sunnah, the Messenger of Allah SAW said, when you debate people of the book, first thing you debate them about, the oneness of Allah. Are you willing to debate that?
Okay. If that is the case, wait, Shamsi,
don't
wait.
Don't run.
Listen, if that is the case, why do you debate other Christians on another topic?
No, always a debate the oneness of Allah, if you notice. Always.
No, Shamsi,
there are videos where you're on the bench or wherever you are, leaning on a fence, debating about someone. Leaning on a fence, debating about something else.
No, the point is that you debate about
other stuff.
Yes or no? Are you lying? Yes or no?
Can I speak?
Go on.
Please, you two,
go on.
Calm down. Let me speak. Okay.
Go on.
Every person, every Christian's here, before I speak to him about anything, I speak about the oneness of Allah. If I notice it's not getting nowhere, then we move on to what? To the Bible. Is it the Bible, the Word of God? Then we move on. So when you see me speaking to a Christian about something else, know that I already spoke to him about the oneness of Allah. I never spoke to you about the oneness of Allah and the oneness of God according to Christians. Are you willing to debate that?
Shamsi, okay, can I just make something clear?
Let's make something clear.
No,
I'm speaking to
you're
him.
Saying on camera.
No, you can speak to both.
One person can be quiet.
Shamsi.
Are you willing to debate
that? He wants to make something clear.
Let's
make it clear.
That's why I'm speak to them. Because they never agree.
He wants to make something clear. Wait, before you leave.
You're saying from now on, okay, from now on, I don't ever want to see you debate a Christian unless it's about the oneness of God. Correct me if I'm wrong. I'm going to repeat it. I'll repeat what you said. Me if I'm wrong.
And play.
You said,
stop it and play.
You said, okay, that you've been told by Allah, you've been told by the Messenger, your prophet, yes? But when you debate a Christian, you must first prioritize debating the oneness of God. And if it's not going nowhere, then you debate about something, another subject.
That's you're right.
Right. So I knew what you said.
So
here's my point again. Right? So from now on, every time I see you debate, you must first, a Christian, you must first debate about the oneness of God, nothing else.
Okay, can I speak now?
No, I have to finish. You don't want to finish.
Excuse
you
me.
Must first,
it's not Paul.
You must first,
don't kill
you
me.
Must first debate about the oneness of God before you debate about any other subject.
So can I clarify that? My point is, can I speak now?
Go ahead.
So my point was to you, to understand this.
Sorry.
My point was to you, if you see me debating a Christian, for example, if I debate a new Christian comes to me, the first thing I like to debate about, the oneness of Allah. Then if the same Christian comes back to me, I will debate him something else. But if there is a new Christian comes to me, without any doubt, the first thing I have to discuss with him is the foundation. However, sometimes a Christian will approach you and they ask you about something else. You understand? But always take them back to the foundation. So are you willing to debate the foundation?
Right. So, okay.
They don't want to say. Why? Because I will destroy them.
Don't run.
I will destroy them. Are you willing to debate
me?
My challenge to you two. Are you willing to debate me about the foundation? About the oneness of God?
Can I respond? It's established. Oneness of God.
Wait, stop. No. We can debate that. Shamsi, wait. I heard you when I came here.
Forget about heard me.
Say, can you show me a scripture from the Quran? Yes. The Arabs are superior.
That's not Christian. It's not Christian. That's not Christian.
But that's what I wanted to debate.
No.
I'm like, okay, come up.
That guy is not Christian. That guy is not Christian.
It doesn't matter.
Because I told you. I just told you, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He said, we need to debate the people of the book, not someone who's atheist. That guy's not people of the book. So are you willing to debate me?
Show me where Muhammad said that.
If I show you, will you debate me?
Show me where Muhammad
said that. No. If I show you the hadith, would you debate me?
Show me first.
No. Would you debate me?
Okay, you know what?
We'll examine it.
You know what?
Okay, you don't have it.
The hadith I know very well. The hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas narrated it. The Messenger of Allah here. But anyway, clueless.
So, okay, for
this is coming with agenda. Not our feet.
My agenda is not to leave Islam.
That's
my
agenda. To leave what?
Islam.
Never.
Leave Islam. That's my agenda.
Watch my videos. People becoming Muslims.
That's my agenda.
Watch my videos. Alhamdulillah.
People said you said I have an agenda. Yeah, that's my agenda. I'm telling you.
Yeah, we've got agenda.
Leave the darkness of Islam and accept the light of Christ. That's my agenda.
That's good.
I'll say over and over again to all Muslims.
That's good. That's good. So you want me to leave the darkness of Islam to come to the light of Jesus? So let us talk about Jesus to be God.
No problem. So you want to change the topic?
Yes. The oneness of God.
No, no, he's talking about Jesus being God.
That's the oneness of God.
But you want to talk about the Tawheed.
Yeah.
So why talking about Jesus being God?
The oneness of God. What is the oneness of God?
Don't leave me. Show me from Sahih al-Bukhari.
Yeah, show him that.
When Muhammad
why
said,
are you saying that? I just want to explain to you because what you're doing is you're giving us the Muslim narrative, yes?
Yeah, he is.
And the Christian narrative is the foundation. The foundation.
That's why.
The foundation of our faith is based on Jesus Christ dying and resurrecting again for our sins.
Amen.
So that's our foundation. So if you're saying it's the foundation, let's debate that foundation then. We'll debate that foundation. We'll debate sin. Sin is the issue that we're dealing with. Sin whether you're coming from an Islamic perspective or a Christian perspective, sin is the issue. So can we debate sin? Can we debate sin? Shamsi, can we debate sin? Can we debate sin?
Bro, brother, I'm not Hatun.
Foundation. Foundation.
No, you can't approach me, correct? Listen carefully. Again,
why
brothers
is
and sisters,
Shamsi,
he approached, let me speak.
The scholar of speakers.
I'm not a scholar. Huh?
But you're an imam, right?
I'm not imam.
Baba, you're not an imam.
Not everyone need to praise imam, to be honest.
Are you an imam?
No, I'm not imam.
Baba, why are you? I came to a mosque.
Yeah.
And you told me you was an imam.
No, you know what, it's imam.
Why would you lie like this?
You know it's imam. No, no, wait. Let me clarify something to him. Yes. Anyone that lead the prayer called imam.
Do you not lead the prayer?
Yeah, but I'm not imam, meaning someone who is appointed to be imam. Me, such I do lead
but
the prayer,
no,
but not appoint imam.
Right, but
who knows the Quran, all of it, and so on, which I don't.
Okay, so you're not an imam.
Mean, are you? He can be imam. He did prayer. Forget all of this. The hadith here, okay? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Which one is it? Read the source.
Well, what source is it?
Surah. The Bukhari, Sahih Bukhari. Sahih Bukhari. Source are Muslim. Is a Muslim this one? Sahih Muslim. Okay. The hadith. Okay.
19.
Okay. Here the hadith. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent Mu'ad to Yemen in order to call people to Islam and teach them to practice. So he said, إِنَّكَ تَأْتِ قَوْمًا أَهْلَ كِتَابًا. Then you are coming to a people among the people of the book. So call them to testify. There is no good but Allah and the Messenger of Allah. Are you willing to talk about the oneness of God?
Wait, okay, no, so that's not what you said. There we go. Respond to that. That's what you said initially.
No, but I don't mind debating.
You're the oneness of God, yeah.
Can we debate your topic for half an hour, my topic for half an hour?
wait. This is half an hour doesn't exist. Topic first.
Before we go to that, yes? He told us
that tell us,
what you said, what you were going to show us, was where the prophet, your prophet says that the first thing you should talk about is the oneness of God. What he just showed us is where he tells you to do it. He didn't say that's priority. He didn't say you can't speak about anything else.
That is priority.
So why is it? Okay. So, okay. I just want to clarify. Brother, I want to clarify. All these Muslims,
I don't want to
that are debating Trinity, and everything they talk about is Trinity.
Yes, that's what it is. So now, what is our goal? If I prove to you that you believe in paganism, would you leave Christianity?
No, you can't prove it.
You can't prove that.
Let us understand that.
Okay. The premise is half an hour of your topic, half an hour of mine.
Can I pick a topic to debate you afterwards? If I destroy you in this, if I'm not listening, therefore, if the foundation is not clear to you, you'll be more stubborn in the other things.
So you don't want to debate? He's already making a premise and he doesn't want to debate me on my own topic, even though I give him his own topic to debate on.
Yes. So why?
You know why? Because I'm saying, imagine now, let me be clear to you.
No.
Imagine if the principle is not clear to someone.
And he's
fighting against clear cut principles. Then he said, you know what? Let us debate branches. If the principle, he got and gets it clearly, let alone the branches, he will be more complicated. So if the foundation, you're not clear upon it, therefore whatever comes after it doesn't matter.
Let the viewers judge.
No, what are you talking about?
Let the viewers judge.
All these yes men don't help. All these fanboys ain't going to do that for
you. So
what we're saying is,
you have half an hour on your subject. Half an hour left. What?
I'm gonna stay here for hours.
No, okay.
Why
I'm
not?
Saying, no. You, wait, wait.
Because,
hey, Baba, don't touch me. So what you're doing is, Excuse me. Some time.
No one speaks on my behalf.
20
Look
minutes.
This guy. Why speak on my behalf? Do you need a lawyer? Does he need a lawyer? Go to it. I moved to you many times. I exposed you many times.
I've come to your mosque.
So what's that mean? I went to church.
So what does that mean? I went to church. No, but I'm saying to you, if you're the one who's exposing me, why would I come to your mosque?
Shamsi, 20 minutes. I'm debating you, but he's just clarifying. If you don't want to debate me on my topic, I can't debate you on yours.
Yes.
So you're not happy to
debate. Let's agree.
So you're not happy to
debate you on yours. Debate me on mine.
So you're not happy to debate me about the first thing that Jesus called to. All hail children of Israel, our God is one. You're not happy to debate me about Moses and Jesus and Abraham and Noah, Jacob called, came to call people to worship one God.
Okay, show us where Paul clarifies that.
What you say, Paul? I said call. Calm down.
I said we can debate that for half an hour and then my topic for half an hour.
It's not your topic, this one.
That's your topic.
So you don't believe in the oneness of God?
Well, I can debate you on that.
Excuses.
Okay, but let me debate your mind.
Let me go.
I'm not going to start. He doesn't agree to it.
I will.
You're going to debate me on yours and then walk away.
Half an hour.
You start.
10 minutes. If I see stop, we'll move on.
You start.
Yeah. Okay. So what's the discussion?
So do you agree?
What is our subject you want?
Do you agree?
What is our subject?
Do you agree though?
You have a 10-minute subject. I'm not agreeing.
Daniel, what's the subject?
I have so many subjects.
The oneness of God.
No, Ekwa. You know what? If we start having a dialogue and I see people interrupting, I have to leave. Because why? I'll say now. Do you know why? Because I know when people interrupt, sometimes you want to say something, they stop you. So what is the topic you want after that?
Okay, so...
So many topics.
Yeah, no.
So many. I'm going to ask you this. Did Muhammad come from the line of Ishmael?
Yes, Muslim came from the line of Ishmael.
Okay, he did, yeah? Okay. That's my topic, then you have to prove it, yeah?
Yeah, you're going to prove that. Okay. Ishmael, yeah?
Okay, good.
Okay, good. What's your question?
We'll start with you and I. We know that God is perfect, correct?
Yes.
Do you believe God, he has a perfect attribute?
Yes, he does.
He knows everything all the times?
Yes.
Can you define what everything all the times? Know everything all the times?
He knows everything, yeah. What is your question?
If he was on the earth, outside the earth, he knows everything all the times.
Okay, what is your point? I don't understand.
My point is clear.
I said to you, he knows everything.
Because you are
so talk. Let's talk for two minutes so we have some kind of order here.
Yeah?
You talk for 2 minutes and I'll respond.
Okay. So you said God knows everything all the times, correct?
Okay.
Likewise, you believe, and I believe, there's no one greater than God.
Okay.
And you believe Jesus and the Father are different beings.
No, it's not.
Is the Father Jesus?
Different person.
That's what I'm saying, different
one
person.
One being.
Yeah, okay.
Being and person are two different things.
Is the Father God?
Yes, he is.
Jesus is God?
Yeah.
Jesus is God. Is it the Father or Adam the Father?
I can answer that to you without interjecting.
Yeah.
Make your point. And then I'm going to talk.
Yeah. I'm asking simply.
No. Make your point.
Shamsi, make your point
and then I will talk.
Okay, my point here is...
When you debate somewhere like in a university, you don't debate like this.
No, you debate like that.
No,
no you don't.
They make their point and then you're quiet and then I'll make my point.
Daniel, we're not university. This is called Speaker's Corner.
I know that.
That's why
we need more order here.
So you don't need university's order.
We need an order here.
Don't come to the...
Make your point.
Don't come to the lion's cage. Okay, let's try to bring the universe. Okay, so now, you as a Christian, you believe, correct me if I'm wrong, that's what I'm saying. You believe the Father is God and Jesus is God. And you believe Jesus had two nature, God nature and a man nature. He is God nature. Is it the Father or other than the Father?
No, it's different.
Different, okay.
Different person.
That's what I'm saying. Okay, so according to the Bible,
half an hour.
We'll finish. If it's not getting nowhere, we'll move on.
Just put the time on.
Okay. I'm taking the time.
Now we move on that. According to the Bible, that Jesus said, no one knows the day and the hour.
Can you take out the Bible? Can we read it?
Mark 13:32. Go.
Yeah. Do you have the Bible with you?
A Muslim knows it, but he doesn't know it.
But you're the one claiming it. I didn't say I don't know it. We can take the Bible out and then dialogue from there.
Yeah.
Because we don't want opinions, you see. Mark 13:32.
Yeah. Let's go to Mark 13.
Interesting. Go on, read it.
No one knows the hour, nor the angel.
I know it. Don't worry, I'll respond.
There's my Bible here.
But he knows it. But he's dragging.
It's the same dry argument you guys use all the time.
Not ever. Always they talk about
but
it.
But of the day and the hour, not even the angels in the heaven, nor the sun. If you can first start speaking, Godwin is the biggest hypocrite. He tells people keep quiet and he speaks.
Brother,
we know that.
But of the day and the hour, no one knows it. Not even the angels in the heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. So Dajj is not the hour.
Can I respond now?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. So Mark 13:32 is the scripture that he brought. Mark 13:32 says, but about that day or hour, no man, no man knows, not even the angels, not even the Son, but only the Father knows it. So listen to what Jesus is saying. He put man first, and then he put angels, and then he put himself, and then he put the Father. So Jesus is above man and angels. Yeah. At that time, Jesus Christ, was a man, incarnate man, where he set aside his glory for a time being. Yeah. And he came on earth to sacrifice himself for us.
Yes.
Yeah. So when he said that, he was still above angels and man. So that means he was still above Muhammad himself and angels.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
As their subjects.
So he put himself above that, which means he knows everything. But at that time, he set himself aside.
Okay.
Yeah. So you're talking about the pre-resurrection. Yeah. Why don't we talk about the post-resurrection, where Jesus died and resurrected? In Revelation chapter 1, verses 8, it says, I am the Alpha and the beginning. I was dead and now I am alive. If you're the Alpha and the Omega, beginning and the end, you know everything.
Yes.
So now we know that Jesus knows everything.
Hallelujah.
But at that time, he set himself aside and he did.
Okay, listen to this lie of our Christian. Why? Because according to Jesus, who knows the Father only? You told me Jesus had two natures.
Yes.
A man nature and a God's nature.
Yes.
And I ask you, he's God. Ikhwa, my brothers, I said it many times.
They're talking among themselves.
Yeah, but I'm interrupting you to hear. Today I'm going to expose you. I know you people to hear speak. So according to Jesus' wording, great messenger, his God nature doesn't know the hour. So he's only the Father. So according to Jesus,
that's a lie.
Okay, let's go back.
Didn't lie. Like
No one.
When did he say God's nature?
When you say God nature, what do you mean? God nature?
You just told me Jesus had two natures, correct?
Yeah, okay.
Is his God nature the Father or other than the Father?
I said to you, his God nature is a different personhood
from the Father.
From the Father.
That's my point.
But I never said his God nature did not know the hour. I didn't say that.
I didn't say you said that. I said Jesus said that.
No, I didn't. Jesus never said that. Jesus was talking as a man.
I understand that.
Okay,
so Jesus had two natures.
Yes.
According to you, Jesus as God, did he know the hour?
Yes.
Okay, Jesus as
man.
God.
As man,
no,
he did it.
Everyone understand that.
Yeah.
Jesus as man, did know the hour.
Yeah.
We know that.
We know.
Jesus as God, did he know the hour?
Yes.
Is Jesus as God the Father or other than the
different
Father?
Different personhood. I answered that
already. That's what I'm saying. So it's not the Father.
So, no, he's not.
That's what I'm saying. So who's owner of the Father?
The Father is one person.
That's what I'm saying.
Jesus is one person.
That's what I'm saying.
Holy Spirit is one person.
Okay.
But one being.
Okay. Yes.
One being.
Doesn't make any sense.
So clear. So clear.
Okay. God is above your intellect. No, no. You said it doesn't make sense.
Can I tell you?
No, you said it doesn't make sense.
Let me finish my point.
Okay, go on.
So according to him, just told us, Jesus as a God nature is not the Father. According to Jesus, who knows the hour?
The Father.
Okay. So Jesus as God, that's not the Father. The Holy Spirit.
Jesus as God, what?
That's not the hour.
No.
He's not the Father, is
Jesus
he?
Never said that. He said the Son.
Can I
speak to you? He said
the Son.
Oh my
Bro.
Lord. Why are you twisted?
Don't only twist. Who? Only who?
Only the Father.
He's Jesus the Father.
But at that time,
He's the Father.
In what way?
In what way? In this way.
In this way. In this way.
Wallahi, I leave you. Say run away.
Don't run away.
You're going.
Because why
you don't want to do my topic. Yeah?
You're stubborn.
Okay,
everyone knows that Jesus said only the Father.
Yeah, he did.
Okay.
I did not.
Okay, who knows the Father? Who knows the hour? The Father or Jesus?
Now every
no. No, you told me God knows everything all the time.
Okay.
Correct?
Let me finish my point.
You said to me in the beginning, God knows everything all the time, correct?
Okay. Yes.
And you said to me Jesus had two nature, God nature and a man nature. Then you told us Jesus, his God nature knew the hour. But according to Jesus, the only one that knows the hour is the Father. Would you agree with me that Jesus as God is not the Father?
Is that clear or not?
But I explained to you, Jesus was talking in his incarnate nature at the time.
Are you serious?
He's quite clear. Right. His incarnate nature. But and then what? I explained to you in Revelation chapter 1. No, I'm not missing the point.
You are.
Because in Revelation chapter 1, Jesus called the Alpha and the Omega.
Okay.
Who is the Alpha and the Omega in the Quran?
No, don't change the subject.
I'm not changing the subject.
No. Why? According to you,
yes.
Jesus had his God nature.
Pre-resurrection and post-resurrection.
I understand that. Okay. When he was on the earth, he had his God nature.
Yes.
Was he full God, fully God?
He was God man fully and God he was man fully and God fully.
So he's fully. That's my
truly
beautiful. God.
Fully.
I love it. So he's fully God, which is his nature. Mm-hmm. According to Jesus, who knows the hour? The Father or Jesus as God?
According to Mark 13?
Yeah.
According to that time?
No, according to Marcos. Of course, according to Mark.
Because according to Jesus. Shamsi.
Stop playing around.
Shamsi, your intellectual ability is going up and down.
Yeah. You too.
Are you talking about
are you
Mark 13, 32 or now?
You're talking about Mark 13, 32.
I answered that question to you.
Okay.
Only the Father. But now Jesus knows the hour.
But you told
what
me,
do you want now?
Daniel, you told me when he was on the earth.
Yeah,
he
was in his incarnation.
He was perfect God, correct?
Yes, he was.
So what does it mean perfect God? Mean he knew the hour.
What does it mean perfect man? What does it mean he was a man?
I'm always asking you, Hashem. Ask him who died on the cross.
Brother, wait.
Shamsi, are you correct?
Okay. Listen carefully. When he was on the earth, he knew the hour. I'm asking you. When Jesus was on the earth, he knew the hour.
No. Jesus didn't know the hour. He said it.
So by telling he was fully God.
As a human.
But he was also man. So he had to act like a man and God.
Are you
condemning the scripture?
I'm condemning the lies in the scripture.
Okay.
Okay.
So if I'm not changing the subject. But you're a Muslim.
Alhamdulillah.
You're a Muslim. Is that what you want to say? You're a Muslim.
Me too.
How can you condemn the Bible as a Muslim? Is that right? Muslim.
The lies.
How can you condemn
the lies of the Bible?
Wait, sir. I'm not debating you, sir. Wait.
How can you condemn the Bible as a Muslim when Allah and Muhammad never had any problem with it?
Okay, first of all, that I have no problem to discuss this subject. Can you go back to Mark 13:32?
I did. I answered it. I don't know what else you want.
You know what?
He's asking me the same question.
Daniel, that's what I said. Daniel, you are saying to me. Look, none of the cameramen speaking, except Daniel. He's not a cameraman. There's a camera to you. Of course,
he's shouting.
He's still interrupting.
Okay, no.
They're still interrupting.
Were you not interrupting earlier?
Well, Daniel, you said to me, correct me if I'm wrong.
You got short memory.
Okay, wait a second. You said to me, Jesus was on earth, correct?
Sneakers, man.
And he had two natures. He had two natures, correct?
Yes.
His God nature on the earth. Was he perfect?
Yes.
So knew the hour.
He's God nature, yes, he knew that.
But according
to
you,
he never said it.
No,
because he was acting as a man.
No, listen,
I think it's clear. He just doesn't want to accept it. If you don't want to accept it, that's fine.
Listen carefully.
You were talking about Jesus.
We're moving on. The conversation is dead.
According to Jesus,
he's not accepting.
Listen carefully. According to Jesus, he was on the earth. You saying to me, when he was on the earth, even Jesus as God knew the hour. But according to Jesus, when he was on the earth, no one knows the hour, only who? The Father. So therefore, Jesus as God, when he was on earth, you claim he was fully, but he doesn't know the hour.
Okay, Shams, did I answer that question?
Yeah, but it doesn't make any sense.
God is above your intellect. So it's not supposed to make everything.
Okay,
that's not supposed
to make sense. Islam, because God's above your intellect.
Excuse me? Are you running away?
No, because it's an argument.
He's running away. He doesn't want to debate my topic.
Debate your topic.
He won't debate my topic.
That's what I said to you.
We've answered you.
Now, alhamdulillah, clarify. I want to clarify something. That's why the Christians, they will never be able to stand in front of the camera and call into their belief. They always try to attack the Muslims. Because how is on
you
the earth?
You haven't seen our camera.
I see you. You're always there. Muhammad this, Muhammad that. Why? Because
so
how is on the earth? You telling people
Muhammad,
that Jesus is God, but God died. God not everything. God became a man, but he never became a man. Even the argument God became a man, he never became a man.
Nobody
because
ever...
he was a God. Again.
How can you condemn the Bible as a Muslim?
That's a good question.
He
doesn't want to talk about any
subject. No, don't worry.
There's a lies.
Can I make that myself?
Look, what is going to his email? That's what I got. This guy got anti-website, Islamic website.
My email is my anti-website?
No, you got
my email is anti-Islamic website.
I didn't say that. Look, so what I said you go to anti-Islamic website.
You're gonna get exposed. You're gonna get exposed, so just calm down. Is Muhammad from the line of Ishmael?
Yes.
Prove it.
Okay, let's see it.
Islam says Muhammad is from the line of Ishmael.
Let's see some proof.
You ran away from it last week, isn't it?
Your imam is here now.
Yeah, of course. Brothers, what I want to say, if I prove to you Muhammad from Ishmael, would you accept it?
You can't.
You can't, he's already made his mind. He's already made up his mind that whatever Muslim going to try to bring us, I'm going to reject it.
Is
there a point? No, would you accept
it?
No, would you accept it?
Where are you going to bring it from?
No, ask me. Give us Islamic sources, we accept it. Are you asking me to bring from Islamic sources?
No, we can prove that.
I'm a Muslim, where am I going to bring it from?
You're from Islamic sources.
So who are you saying? He was Islamic sources.
Prove it.
Islamic sources.
Good.
Yeah. But you accept it.
Why would we accept the Islamic source?
So why are you asking me?
No, we're saying.
No, because as a Muslim, you don't have it. That's why you're running away. And you're asking red herring questions because he doesn't have it. Don't run away.
He's deflected.
We're getting somewhere.
Hadith, look, Ishtabani. No, this Masakin, you know.
No, we don't have to move.
We have to move, brother. We want to run us over.
We've got space. Don't worry about it. We've got space.
It's three vans.
Hey, keep the circle.
Yeah. Alhamdulillah, I destroyed him in the oneness of God. Doesn't make it
in your own mind. The viewers decide.
We're all together in this, yeah?
What do you mean?
It's not about destroying anybody or anything.
I don't know what these guys are.
We're here to learn.
Do you want to get on the van?
It's a kind of destroying.
We're here to learn.
We're not here to take a personal.
We're here to all be one together. You know, at the end of the day, you're Christian, I'm Muslim. One of us has to go to hell with it.
That's
where the problem comes. We're all here. We're all. You know, where it's cool, you know what I'm saying? We'll get to that, you know what I'm saying?
So we'll find out if Shamsi is going to show us Muhammad is from the line of Ishmael. Let me just remind the viewers, Ishmael was from Egypt. Muhammad was from Mecca.
Ishmael was from Egypt, don't lie. Ishmael was from Egypt.
That's what we believe.
So you're going to use your belief as a criteria for my belief?
No.
Look, red herring.
Find it.
Prove to me, according to the Egyptian historians that spoke about Ishmael in Egypt.
There is a war of words.
They are arguing peacefully. We are learning. You
should go from there, bro.
You know what I'm saying?
You should go from there.
No, we have to go from there.
No, we look to
each other. What's the question?
It's not a question. It's just.
They never get a war.
You're going off something palatable.
Just indeed.
But did you understand?
It's a debate.
About the oneness of God.
About Jesus and God. How can Jesus be God if
you
didn't know they are one?
I know the Hadith. What?
That's the Arabic. I'm sorry.
You speak your mother's tongue.
Don't listen.
My mother's tongue? Whose mother's tongue? No, it's not our mother's tongue. It's a lie.
He's telling me. He's telling me my mother's tongue is Arabic.
No, it's not. You're wrong.
No. Wait.
Believe yourself, mate.
Eddie King is fool.
Why are you insulting?
Wait. Okay, the hadith. This hadith on authority of Wathiyah ibn Sa'd. The messenger of Allah, so it's in Tirmidhi.
the hadith authentic?
And tell me this. So I don't understand this. This is all Arabic.
I'm going to narrate it to you and just check it.
No. Show us in English because we will speak English.
Bro. I'm gonna, you asked me for proof, correct?
Yeah, we have English audience.
No, I'm going to translate it. You don't have to.
How can we trust you?
He's running.
No problem. The viewers can translate.
No. We want it now.
No.
Because you're going to walk up like you want to debate.
No. Anyway, you need the proof. Because you told me, let the viewers judge. Did you say that?
No,
did you say that or not?
The viewers, they are English audience.
I'm going to translate for them then.
No,
but from
show
you.
Us. No, from the show hadith.
How do we know?
Go on, we'll
interrogate him.
Okay. No, don't let him get away with it. He'll say, walk off like a
good interrogator.
What I'm going to do now, I'm going to mention the hadith, translate it, mention sources, I'm going to keep it moving. Not for them, I want the Christian to become Muslim. I want you to finish.
You're going
to
go.
I will move. Because you asked me for the proof, I'm going to give you the proof.
We need to analyze the proof.
Are you a scholar of hadith?
I don't need to be.
What?
Okay. Are you a scholar of hadith?
I study hadith.
No, are you a scholar?
You're not either.
So we're even. Yeah? No, we're even.
Yeah. We're not.
You're not a scholar.
You know why?
You're not a scholar of hadith. I'm not a scholar of hadith. We're even.
So we're even.
Why?
Because scholars of hadith says authentic.
Okay, but you're not a scholar.
But you're not sure. You can't prove it.
Which scholar said? Which scholar of hadith you going back to?
Anyway, let me translate. Read it.
The hadith, the Messenger of Allah said. He said that Allah. Okay. Inna Allah astafa Kanana min wal Ismail. Allah has chosen Kanana from the sons of Ismail, and He's chosen Quraysh from Kinana, and He chose Quraysh from Bani Hashim, and He chose me from Bani Hashim. So Prophet Muhammad is the son of Hashim, the son of Quraysh, the son of Kinana, the son of Ismail. Look at this.
You're gonna go.
Look at
him running
away.
Typical. Coward. He just runs away. He reads his Arabic text, who no one understands. 80% of Muslims don't know Arabic. And he reads Arabic and he goes away. We definitely know Muhammad was never from the line of Ishmael. It's a lie on the website of hell.
Anti-Islamic website.
That's what it is. He went onto an Arabic website and he's like reading Tirmidhi. We don't even know where he's from. We know the Torah says Egypt. Ishmael's from Egypt.
Yes.
And we know Muhammad was from Mecca.
Yes.
We know his grave. He's dead, buried, and gone. Mecca and Egypt are miles apart.
Who has the Bible?
You can't answer that question.
Who runs away.
Islamic Dawah team run away over and over again. We don't run away because Jesus is the truth. We don't run away from deception. We confront it in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We come to know the true Christ.
What's his name?
God bless you. Jesus.